Up next, the former president of Rashawn Sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, and author Dorothy Buchanan, I'm sorry, Wilson, on how to be a leader. We'll be right back. Lord, I know better. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest says, your life should be defined by how much you positively impact others. And she exudes that every single day. In her new book, You Can Lead, 30 Life Lessons to Empower the Leader Within, she gives you a how-to guide on how to do just that. I recently had the honor of sitting down with author and former president of my sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Dorothy Buchanan Wilson. Take a look. My friend, my soror, Dorothy Buchanan Wilson. Welcome to Sister Circle.
Well, thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm so excited.
Yes, awesome,
thank
awesome,
you.
Awesome. So we got to get into this book. And one of the things that you talk about is that leaders are made and not born. Tell me a little bit about that and why you believe that is to be true.
Well, I think when you talk about leaders, we always hear that leaders are born and that you need a certain skill set or a certain amount of talent to be a leader. Well, I know, based on my experience and based on the experience of others, that leaders are made primarily by the experiences that shape your life.
Yes.
A lot of the young people that we know, and a lot of us as young people, we were entrusted with responsibility as family members, whether it's taking care of our younger siblings or taking care of the house while our parents worked. And so those were the foundation blocks for early leadership experiences. And so that's why I base my book and my thought on the fact that leaders are indeed made because we have a lot of experiences that kind of stack on and build on each other.
Yeah.
And that's what ultimately helps you with your leadership success.
Yes, and it helped you tremendously. You alluded to, you know, being the head of a household, and you actually did that.
Yes.
At 14 years old, you were raised by your grandparents, 34 grandchildren, and you were the one that really, really kind of catapulted yourself. And you give all the credit to your grandparents. Tell us how that was for you and how it developed into this beautiful woman that sits next to me today.
Thank you. A part of my story that I like to share is the fact that at the age of, actually started at the age of 11, but by the time I was 14 was when my sister kind of moved away. And then that did mean that there were three very young siblings in a household with two very frail grandparents. And so a part of that, having to help with them, having to basically help manage the household, that really influenced me early in, because I've learned how to accept responsibility, how to take care of others, but more importantly, how to make crucial decisions.
Yes.
And that's a big part of the whole leadership piece, which is making decisions, taking care of your staff, taking care of your people, but more importantly, understanding how things work and how to make things work. I mean, that was a part of my journey. And so I would say probably my foundation block started at the age of 11 or 14, however you want to look at it. But certainly it started with my grandparents, Mr. Lucius Wilson, who instilled in us how to be confident, even as youngsters, to take care of major responsibilities. And then that comfort translated into him saying to at least those of us who were living with him, I think someone needs to go to college. We were a family of very hard workers, but we weren't necessarily a college-educated family. My grandfather basically put that into play, and I entered college with the confidence, primarily because I'd been doing so much for 5 years in high school, helping to run the household. So it was easy for me to make that transition to go to college and to be successful.
Yes, yes, yes. And you have been highly successful, 30 years in corporate and nonprofit. How did that, coming from where you came from, then you go into this corporate space, nonprofit space, leading an entire sorority, how did that help you to create or become the leader that you have become today? And what have you learned from those experiences?
Right. I think back to the earlier premise of everything adds. I actually was educated at two very wonderful historically black colleges and universities, Benedict College, my undergraduate degree, and then Clark Atlanta University right here in Atlanta for my master's degree. And I would say that those two experiences of being in that environment where we were nurtured and supported thoroughly for 6 years definitely helped me have the confidence to come out and to pursue a corporate career. And I did pursue some very serious corporate opportunities, both at Xerox Corporation, at SC Johnson Wax, and then later on in a nonprofit arena at Goodwill. And in those positions, I learned that definitely your foundation, your support system, your basically what you bring to the table Those things are all important, but basically being there and having a voice and not being afraid to use your voice.
Yes.
To not only advocate for what you think is right, not only in the workplace, but just for women and others who are there with you in general. And then all of those experiences rolled up helped me to move into the position of international president of Alpha Kappa Alpha. And again, that is a very, even though it's an organization that's about service, it's an organization that has a lot of infrastructure and process.
It's a business.
And so those skill sets were transferable there. And I was able to do so much with the over 300,000 members and volunteers because we were able to move forward as a collective body, and I brought that basic, that nonprofit, mm-hmm. as well as that executive level skill set to the table.
Oh, we saw it and we loved it. It was absolutely impeccable.
Impeccable
leadership.
Thank you.
And but you believe that everybody can lead, mm-hmm. which is why you wrote
Yes.
You Can Lead. You have a lot of pointers in your book. Mm-hmm. What are two or three that stand out to you the most that are easily relatable to the everyday person?
Right. I do believe that everyone can lead, and that's why the book is written from the standpoint of the reader.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can lead. It's not about me as a leader. And three major points I would say is, number one, definitely make sure that you understand that you make a difference. So when you come to the table with your unique skill sets and your experiences, that you can be that difference, and you can make the difference, and you can have the impact. Not only locally, but certainly globally as well. So that's number one. Number two, I think in today's society, it's important that leaders understand that you must be not only savvy in people management skills, but that whole technology piece.
You have to be.
I say there's a whole chapter on being a techie and not being afraid to own that, because
yes.
you need to understand not only where the technology is, but where it's headed.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you integrate those skills into your overall leadership style? And then the third thing that I think is important for us as leaders, it's understanding that you must pay it forward.
Yes.
You know, a lot was poured into us as young people, as young leaders, and we benefited from it tremendously. Now we have to make sure that we're imparting that into future generations. And so a big part of what I'm talking about is, I'm going out talking about You Can Lead, is saying, pay it forward, invest in others, whether it's mentees that you're working with or young people or those in your community, but be willing to take those same, lessons in nurturing, making sure that you're successful, and then putting that forward into that next generation
yes,
of leaders.
Absolutely.
If we don't invest in them, it won't happen. So that whole idea of paying it forward is a big part of the message of this You Can Lead tour.
Yes, and I'm so happy you mentioned the You Can Lead tour, because you have got a couple of dates coming up
right.
that we want people to make sure, if you're in those cities, to go and catch this amazing woman live and in person, so you can talk about this book and really impart some more knowledge
right.
to the everyday person.
Right.
Where will you be on the 28th?
Houston, Texas is where we will be. Certainly would like to have your viewers join us there, where we will be talking in that city about, and the format is, there's a presentation with a lesson from the book, and then we have a very animated, lively discussion about mm-hmm. that lesson, and then take questions and answers from the audience, and then I sign books and take pictures.
Yes.
And so it's not just a meet and greet. It really is a lot of information being shared.
Yes.
In that city.
Good. Well, I'm really glad that you're using your time wisely, because you've been leading us for the last 4 years, and now you get a time to
yes.
breathe and do you.
Yes, I sure do.
Yes,
thank you.
Yes, well, we certainly are so glad that you've come down to the circle to share your knowledge, and I get to be in the presence of royalty,
right.
and I held her hand.
Right. And thank you for what you do.
Oh.
You have a wonderful platform, and you're using it to elevate women, but more importantly, to spread positive messages
thank
about
you.
What we do and what we're capable of. So I appreciate you having me here to talk about You Can Lead.
Thank you. See, look at this. This is royalty, and she said that about me. Yes. Dorothy Buchanan Wilson, thank you so much for your time today. We appreciate you.
Thank
you. And continued success on everything.
Thank you so much.
You're
appreciate
welcome.
Being here.
Could you tell I was happy about
yes.
it?
Very excited.
Oh, that was good.
It was wonderful interview.
Thank you kindly. I appreciate it. Such an honor. Do yourself a favor and pick up a copy of Dorothy's book, You Can Lead, 30 Life Lessons to Empower the Leader Within. And to find out more about her and her book tour, please follow her at D. Buchanan Wilson.